Hello and welcome. We're going to get into the first of the real questing in Mass Effect 3. We need help from other races, so we're going around the council's back because, as per usual, they don't want to help us. So we're going to go get the Turian Primarch and through this get some goodwill and get some help for Earth, because remember, Earth is really, we're heavy under attack, and everybody else is like, no, we are too, we need preparation, which is like logical, I get it, but it's not nice and unfortunate. So I honestly have to say I forget the scanning process in this, so that's why I'm checking. It's a lot less burdensome than 2 or 1, I feel like, the exploration. Alright, it says Palavin's largest moon, Mane, has been shrouded in secrecy since the dawn of Turian Space Age. You can read that if you want to. Sorry. I put on perfume today and I'm suffering the consequences of that. I'm like sneezing and I have a cough. Do not do. Oh, okay, we can't take Javik yet, I forgot. That's probably why we could have waited and got him, but it's okay. Not gonna mess with that right now. Let's see, anything else? I haven't gotten rid of this. Yeah, attack range. Oh god, that's important. Yeah, let's do that. Let's see if that makes it a better upgrade. So we shall see. Liara, nothing. I don't really use stasis. I find it dumb. There we go. I'm really excited about a new system in the new Mass Effect game after the trilogy to come out, because from what I can tell, you can pick around through the different, you know, trees, so instead of being infiltrator or whatever, you can be like, well, I want this from engineering, and which I find fascinating, and I'm excited, and I am going to try to play some of that on my channel the next game, Mass Effect Andromeda. I really want to. And I am getting early access, so I might play those first, at least, I think it's 10 hours of content. I don't know. Or 10 hours that you can, I don't know. But I really might, so we shall see. It's kind of a personal experience the first time I play in a game or watch a show or anything like that. It's like, I don't want to rush, I don't want to, so it might be a different type of game when I don't know what I'm doing at all.
Oh no. No. Palavin. We have an old friend there.
Holy hell. They're getting decimated.
Strongest military in the galaxy, and the Reapers are
obliterating. Yeah, we could call Garrus an old friend.
Was it like this on Earth?
Alright.
Yes.
Shepard. I'm so sorry.
It's yeah. Okay. You couldn't have done it.
Commander,
anything.
The LZ is getting swarmed.
James, open that hatch.
Get in, get out. Let's move!
Thank you.
I wanted to test him. Damn it. That was too much. Hold on. It doesn't have anything to say. Well, that's fine.
Hold your fire. Friendly inbound.
I really like this color combo, though. Like the blue and the purples and the highlight of like pinky purple. It's cool. But stuff is bad here, in case you can't tell. Like, the Reaper threat was real, y'all. It was not a joke. Just checking around. Oh, ammo. Ammo? Ammo? Yay.
Sir, shuttle care. The fighter mechanics is not alive.
Okay.
Tabestic, get your men up on that north barricade.
Yes, sir.
Sergeant Bardas, find a way to get that comm tower operational.
Sir.
General?
Commander Shepard. Heard you were coming, but I didn't believe it. General Corinthus.
I've come to get Primarch Fedorian.
Primarch Fedorian is dead. His shuttle was shot down an hour ago as he tried to leave the moon.
I mean,
that's gonna complicate things.
That was a sad noise.
How bad is it, General?
We just lost about 400 men in half an hour. We set up camps on this moon as an advanced position to flank the enemy. A sound strategy, just...
irrelevant.
Exactly. The sheer force of the Reapers seems to make them immune to that sort of tactic. The Primarch and his men found that out the hard way.
Let me do it first. Damned Reapers. Wait, no, it's not... Damned Reapers. No, that's a bit much. Damned Reapers. That's a bit resigned. All right, you take it away, Shep.
I'm sorry. That's a big loss for everyone.
See, she doesn't even say it.
Bastards.
Oh, Reaper bastards.
So what happens now?
Damned Reapers.
The Turian hierarchy provides very clear lines of succession.
Sorry. Right, General Corinthus.
With such heavy casualties, it's hard for me to be certain who the next Primarch is. Palavan Command will know. However, at the moment, contacting them is impossible. The comm tower is out. Husks are swarming that area. We can't get close enough to repair it.
Well, I'm not leaving this moon until I know where the Primarch is. I'll fix your tower.
Thank you, Commander. I'll take care of things on this end.
All right, let's go.
I'll do all the dangerous work. Cool.
I see the comm tower, to the left of the main barricade in front of Palavan.
Let's go!
Commander Hexnar, RE Supplies. They sent us winter gear. Not sure what they thought we'd do with that kind of gear here, but I suppose we should thank the spirits nonetheless. The power sources can be cannibalized and converted to power our combat gear's filtering units instead, at least. It'll be nice not to have those clogging up anymore. I don't like doing that, like, when I'm out on a mission. But, yeah.
Husks at the tower overwhelmed us.
Hey! Let's give him a chance to do his thing. Come here. No, let my boy take it. Let me see. Everything? Hello? Hello, guys. Guys, what should we call him? I feel like the name Marvin fits, you know? I don't know. I guess there's nothing else. That's disappointing.
We can't repair it from this panel. Liara, see if you can repair it.
Yeah, I mean,
I'll go up and have a look.
After,
if you can keep husks from climbing up behind me, I'd appreciate it.
I wouldn't be asking James to do that, but yeah.
Here they come.
Ready, James?
Hell yeah! Let's.
Alright, I'm gonna let him work. Do some. Oh, good boy. Gotta love it. Useful.
Shepard, I've repaired the tower's main satellite connection.
Wow.
On my way down.
Come on.
General, do you read? Comm tower is now operational.
Much appreciated, Commander. I'll contact Palafin Command.
Let me know when you've got something. I'll help your men till I hear from you.
Understood.
Shepard out.
No, I like him. He's useful.
Commander Shepard.
Yeah, I like him.
Go ahead.
I have information from Palafin Command. Please return ASAP.
On our way.
Oh, this way? Oh, damn it. I'm stuck. Oh, that way. Okay, hold on. Sorry, okay.
What have you got?
As your partner said, succession is usually simple. But right now, the hierarchy's in chaos. So many dead are MIA.
I need someone, I don't care who, as long as they can get us the Turian resources we need.
I'm on it, Shepard. We'll find you the Primarch.
Garrus.
Vicarian, sir. I didn't see you arrive.
At ease, General.
You're alive.
I'm hard to kill. You should know that.
Good to see you again. I thought you'd be on Palafin.
If we lose this moon, we lose Palafin. I'm the closest damn thing we have to an expert on Reaper forces, so I'm advising.
James, this is Garrus Vicarian. He helped me stop the collectors. He's a hell of a soldier.
Lieutenant, good to see you too, Liara.
Good to see you in one piece, Garrus.
There's no
General
hostility,
Corinthus,
and I appreciate it.
We
Thank
know
you.
Who we're after.
Palafin Command tells me that the next Primarch is General Adrian Victus.
Victus? His name's crossed my desk.
Know him, Garrus?
I was fighting alongside him this morning. Lifelong military. Gets results, popular with his troops. Not so popular with military command. Has a reputation for playing loose with accepted strategy.
What do you mean?
On Tatris, during the uprisings, his squad discovered a Salarian spy ring about the same time the Turian separatists did. Rather than neutralize the ring, he fell back. He even gave up valuable fortifications which the rebels took.
Then the rebels attacked the Salarians, and when both groups had worn each other down, Victus moved back in. didn't lose a man.
Bold strategy, but wild behavior doesn't get you advanced up the meritocracy.
Primarch Victus. That should be something to see.
I mean, to be real, that's how I got moved up, but that's not how they work. And I respect it, but my wild... What did he say? Erratic? I don't remember, but it worked for me, so...
Unconventional thinking might be the only way to save Palavin and Earth.
He'll do whatever it takes. Reminds me of an old human specter I
know.
Okay, let's get him on the
Thank
shuttle
you.
And get out of here.
Commander!
That is true.
Shepard, come in.
Can this wait, Joker? We're in the middle of a war zone.
We've got a situation on the Normandy, Commander. It's like she's possessed. Shutting down systems, powering up weapons. I can't find the source.
I need the Normandy standing by. We may have to bug out.
Yeah.
Should I go back and take a look?
Do it. Garrus, you said you were with Victus this morning?
Yeah, but we got separated. He went to bolster a flank that was breaking. Could be anywhere out there.
We're trying to raise him, Commander.
Incoming harvester! Headed for the airfield!
Ooh, I actually like how they look. I mean, they look like birds and bugs in one, and that's better than just bugs, you know? I'm much more into the bird
General,
bug.
General, tell Primarch Victus we'll rendezvous here. In the meantime, let's go take care of whatever that thing dropped off. Coming, Garrus?
Are you kidding?
Coming
I'm
on.
Right behind you.
Oh, wait, where did Liara go? Shoot. I feel like that was probably explained and I didn't realize. Ground report, knowledge of the terrain is our only advantage here, and that's not going to last forever if they keep throwing their forces at us. We'll hold this area as long as we can. I'm linking my transponder to the life signal monitoring system of the unit suits. If it goes out, send another unit here ASAP. Intense. I go this way? There's probably an arrow, but I'm just gonna walk. I hope it's this way. Can you? No? No? Mm. Is that guy just hiding? Hold on. Oh, he's not hiding. He's just resting. Are you injured? What are you doing? Is he dead? No, he's breathing. Yeah, if you look at my crosshair, I'll put it on his eye. This is the playthrough you're getting. Yeah, he's breathing. He's just laying there. Okay. Poor guy. I hope he's injured, otherwise we gotta talk about that. Really? We're dying for you, sir? Sir? Oh, do I need this? Yeah. Okay, moving on.
Atmosphere's a little thinner than I'm used to, is all. Adrenaline's better than oxygen. Next day.
not close enough. It's a game, really. Seeing what's up.
We're done here.
I feel like sometimes I overmanage these situations because I'm like trying to avoid stuff, but I'm working on it.
Shepard, come in.
Go ahead.
Still trying to raise the Primarch, but we've got trouble back here at the main barricade. If the Reapers breach it, we're done.
On my way.
Record, I don't ever want to do anything like that in actual life. But is that a Turian mixed with something else? I never noticed that before. Some, like, or is he just playing the head of a Turian? Managing it like that is ultimately the best thing to do.
Shepard, Corinth is here.
You know, because then you're good.
What's the word of the Primarch?
Still can't get a stable comm link.
Okay, I'm going on foot. Shepard out. Garrus, take me to the last place you saw Victus. How far?
Should be pretty quick, unless we find trouble.
Yeah, because we've absolutely never found trouble before, ever.
Damn it. Look at Palavin. That blaze of orange. The big one. That's where I was born.
That's rough. Still have family there?
My dad. A sister.
How bad is it?
3 million lost the first day. 5 the second.
How's your military holding up?
Look around. That should give you some idea.
Now you're putting up a good fight.
For now. But how long does it take before the fight's kicked out? If they'd only listened to your warnings about the Reapers, we might have been ready.
Maybe. Hard to figure how you prepare for something like this.
Well, you do more. you doing more than just like... Well, some people were. I mean, we know that now. Some people definitely were. Other people listen, but it's not something you find out till later. Oh my god, I threw it off the cliff. It's kind of useless. Let's see what you do, baby. Go. Marvin. Thank you. Oh. So rude.
Shit, I hate those things.
Me too.
And New York is crawling with the creepy bastards? I never should have left Earth.
It's gonna be bad all over.
Leaving the fight just pisses me
I'm
off.
I'm calling my...
But you're here asking Victus to do the same thing.
I'm sorry.
Leave the fight to make nice talk, in Garrus. Some boardroom.
This summit is the only chance we've got. None of us is beating the Reapers alone.
Very true. But I'm headcanoning. I've said it before that my drone in Mass Effect Andromeda is has cat ears, and I'm calling her Tabby. Vicky Tabitha, okay?
Soldier, you okay?
Marvin isn't quite
yes,
as clever.
Sir. We'll make it.
Or as lame.
Have you seen General Victus?
Half hour ago. And it's down.
Okay, good luck.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good luck. Wait, is this the way we go?
How many troops in that crash? 50? 75?
Oh,
not sure.
Sounds right.
Hard to see a beautiful ship like that go down.
Not to mention the men serving on her.
Yeah.
Yeah. We should go.
That was a little closer than I'd like.
I'll say. So, Commander, you really think this summit will work? I mean, Asari? Salarians? Where's the Krogan and Batarians? Where's the meat?
It's not that easy.
The Batarians took the first hit when the Reapers arrived. Not much left of them. And the Krogan have never forgiven us for the Genophage.
Right. Turians sterilized them.
Salarians came up with it.
And the Krogan hate them both for it.
So they won't be joining us.
Too bad. I fought with the Krogan. They're tough sons of bitches.
Okay, double time. No Reaper's taking this Primarch from me.
Right behind
to the compound.
Moving.
Right behind you.
Go off fast enough is a real problem. Shrines on the Altar one. Still. Oh boy, I ran out of ammo. I wasn't using my snipey, but... God, I was supposed to get that. Well, that explains why it took so much ammo. But, like you said, it's okay, I got one left. Where'd that thing go? Yeah, like I said, I guess I was supposed to use that, but now I have it, so I can use
General
it on
Victus?
A harvester or something, which is a bird thingies.
I'm Commander Shepard of the Normandy.
Not Commander. I know who you are. I can't wait to find out what brings you out here. Vicarian, where did you go?
Heavy Reaper unit on the right flank. I believe your exact words were, get that thing the hell off my men.
Appreciate it.
General, you're needed off-planet. I've come to get you.
It will take something beyond important for me to leave my men or my Turian brothers and sisters in their fight.
Fedorian was killed. You're the new Primarch.
You're needed immediately to chair a summit and represent your people in the fight against the Reapers.
I'm Primarch of Palavin.
Oh boy.
Negotiating for the Turian hierarchy?
Yes.
I've spent my whole life in the military. I'm no diplomat. I hate diplomats.
What makes you think you're not qualified?
I'm not really a by-the-book kind of guy, and I piss people off. My family's been military since the Unification War. War is my life. It's in my bones. But that kind of passion is deceptive. It can make you seem reckless when you're anything but.
This is crucial. I need you on top of your game. Are you in or out?
What's your tone, Commander?
Look, you've met the Reapers head on. You're overqualified.
My tone.
See this devastation, sure. Primarch? Double that for Earth. I need an alliance. I need the Turian fleet.
Give me a moment to say goodbye to my men.
Mm-hmm.
Without him down here, there's a good chance we lose this moon.
Without him up there, there's a good chance we lose everything.
Look at that. And they want my opinion on how to stop it? Failed CSEC officer, vigilante, and I'm their expert advisor? Think you can win this thing, Shepard?
Yeah. I don't know, Garrus, but
I'm sure as hell gonna give it my best shot.
I'm damn sure nobody else can do it. For whatever it's worth, I'm with you.
Welcome
aboard.
It's worth
a lot, my friend.
Are you ready, Primarch Victus?
One thing. Commander, I appreciate your need for our fleets, but I can't spare them. Not while my world is burning. But if the pressure could be taken off Palavin...
That's a pretty tall order.
We need the Krogan. I can't see us winning this thing without them. Get them to help us, and then we can help you.
The Krogan.
Looks like your summit just got a lot more interesting.
Well, I did.
Apologize for being so frank, Commander, but your plan feels doomed to failure. We know. We've been there before.
But, Madam Counselor, let me...
I'm not the only one that feels this way. The Salarian Dalatras is livid.
Some of these issues are hundreds of years old. Time to let go.
Perhaps. Still, we can't help but feel that this summit is a waste of your time. And we can't afford to have it waste ours.
Oh.
We must focus our attention on the arrival of the Reapers.
What are you worth?
So no, the Asari will not be at your summit.
What are you doing?
Our alliance would be stronger with the Krogan. You need them. We all do.
Good luck, Commander.
You know?
And goodbye.
What happens later on is kind of your fault then, isn't it,
Miss Jackass?
Angry.
Commander, thank you for allowing me the use of your ship. And for going along with this plan. Garrus said he had to attend to the Normandy's weapon systems. Something about calibrations.
Oh god.
It sounds like Garrus. I'm sorry to say the Asari counselor won't be joining us. She thinks there's too much bad blood with the Krogan.
She may be right. But there'll be a lot more blood. Real blood. If we don't try.
And when you put it that way...
The sooner we have this summit, the sooner we'll know. Is there something else I can help you with?
I understand this is a difficult time for you, Primarch, but Earth can't survive without reinforcements. Can I still count on your help?
If the Krogan help us on Palavin, then I give you my word.
How is it being the Primarch?
Not what I imagined. The battle of all time is happening on Palavin, and I'm light years away. Reading casualty reports in the millions. If I'm going to die, I want to be with my men, so there's no doubt we fought to the last soul.
I understand. Leaving Earth to save it, it's one of the hardest things I've ever done.
I'm not surprised. Garrus speaks highly of you. You never asked to be a leader, yet your people will die if you refuse. We find ourselves in similar circumstances. Let's hope the spirits grant us the strength to see it through.
He looks a bit blurry. I don't know why.
How are things on Palavin?
The casualty reports are staggering.
Maybe it's
the Reapers are using our own tactics against us. Destroy the enemy with overwhelming force.
I've seen the same on Earth.
The strategist in me admires their brutality. The Turian in me knows I'm watching the destruction of 15,000 years of civilization. My civilization.
I did that right.
Thank you, Primarch. My thoughts are with Palavin.
And mine with Earth.
Well, I mean, wait, is this the... No, it's that way. Hold on. Ah! Dang it. It's stuck when I'm holding my key to talk, and then... okay.
Commander, have you retrieved the Primarch for your summit?
Yes, sir, but the Asari are staying on the sidelines.
They'll regret that. The time for unity is now.
They really
will. The Salarians will be there, though.
You don't sound very optimistic.
We expect the Krogan will be joining us, too.
I see. Well, then you've got your hands full, Commander. Was there something else you needed to discuss?
Didn't we already...
Have you pieced together how the Reapers hit Earth?
It wasn't all that complicated, really. They surged through the relays and hit Arcturus Station before we knew what was happening. From there, it was a short jump to the Sol system. Earth didn't stand a chance.
Sending us to the Mars archives was a good call.
Still doesn't make up for the fact that the Reapers nailed us to the wall. I sacrificed the entire Second Fleet to provide cover for the Third and the Fifth to retreat. Hell, I presided over the most devastating military defeat in human history.
How do you see us winning this war, Admiral?
By making you the tip of the spear.
I'm flattered, but the Normandy's just one ship.
And a fast one. You can move quickly, hit a target, and leave before the enemy has time to react.
That's an advantage, but can it win a war?
It's the larger principle that matters. We'll never defeat the Reapers in a full frontal assault, Shepard. The battle against Sovereign 3 years ago took everything we had, and that was just one Reaper.
I haven't forgotten.
So I'll find their soft spots, avoid them where they're strong, and hit them where they're not. And when I find gaps in the armor, I'll hammer them with every soldier, ship, and bullet we've got.
How long can we keep that up?
As long as it takes. The reality is, Shepard, everything I'm doing is a delaying action for you. I'm buying us time, keeping us in the game while you gather what we need for this Prothean device. So keep at it.
Has your analysis of the Prothean device turned up anything?
Liara appears to be right. It's a weapon of some sort. A big one. Beyond that, we really can't say, other than it's going to be a hell of a thing to try and build.
Do you think it's risky, building something like this when we don't even know what it does?
To be honest, the thing scares the hell out of me, but the Reapers have forced our hand. 2 centuries ago, scientists faced the same problem in the Second World War. They weren't sure what the atomic bomb might do. Some thought it could even ignite Earth's atmosphere, but they did it anyway.
Any updates on Cerberus?
They're still the wild card here. Hitting the archives on Mars suggests they're after the same thing we are. A way to defeat the Reapers.
It didn't seem as if the elusive man was suggesting we appease them. Not like Saren did. You'd think we'd be on the same side now more than ever.
Cerberus has never played by the rules as we know them. I don't know what their agenda is, but it has nothing to do with humanity's best interests.
The elusive man talked about controlling the Reapers. He seemed to think that's how we win this.
He's wrong. Dead Reapers are how we win this.
Doesn't mean he won't try.
I saw your report on that Cerberus soldier you found on Mars. If the elusive man is good at one thing, it's finding new ways to subvert science. It's never worked for him before, and it won't now.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
Okay, well. So, never fully understood the system, but I just know, that I gotta get that number uber high, so should be fun. And it shows you what you got, and little by little, you somehow have enough, hopefully. And I am going to go for, like, the maximum amount of galactic readiness. Oh, shit.
Commander, Edie just went offline.
What do you mean, offline?
I don't know. She's not responding, and I can't access the AI core diagnostics. You better get down to Deck 3.
Commander, comm systems are going haywire.
Yeah, I know. I'm going. Going, guys, because clear. Hold on. Chakwas, same. Sorry, is what's her face there too? Jenkins. Kelly Chambers, Caden. Oh, I'm sorry, friends. I have failed you.
Joker, what's that sound?
Fire extinguishers, Commander. Could be an electrical fire. Or something.
I'm going in. Edie, talk to me.
Thank you.
What?
Is there a particular topic you wish to discuss, Shepard?
Oh boy. She's so silver.
Edie.
Wouldn't it be great if Edie was a lesbian?
You're in Dr. Eva's body. Not all of me, but I have control of it. It was not a seamless transition.
They gave her a female voice, but I don't really think of her
as
having a gender.
You blacked out on us for a while there.
But it's not my choice.
When we brought this unit on board,
either way,
I began a background process to search for its information on the Prothean device. This eventually triggered a trap. A backup power source and CPU activated, and the unit attempted physical confrontation. Fortunately, I was able to gain root access and repurpose it as I saw fit. During this process, it struggled, thus the fire.
Well, if it means having full access to the Prothean data in its head, good work.
I reasoned along similar lines.
Yeah,
so
I appreciate
if you're in
it.
There, are you still in the ship?
I exist primarily within the ship. For optimal control, this unit should remain within Normandy's broadcast or tight beam range.
Are you planning to take that body somewhere?
Normandy's weaponry is not suited to every combat situation. This platform could provide limited fire ground support.
Ooh.
You mean you could come with us?
Yeah.
Correct. This body could accompany you to areas the Normandy cannot reach.
I'll tell you when I need it.
Excellent. I will run tests to ensure that it matches or exceeds the capabilities of organic squad mates. However, my first step should be restoring functionality to the Normandy to reassure the crew that all is normal.
Just don't be surprised if the crew's a little wary of your new body. It was shooting at them a little while ago.
An excellent point. I will take it to the bridge.
But it was wearing a
Joker
skin
will also
at one
want
point,
to see it.
So. Oh god, Joker.
On that we can agree.
Yep. I think we should talk to Garrus because I have like a minute for that before our jet, or more accurately, get up.
In a matter of hours.
I know, Primarch. I'm seeing the same numbers myself. They don't look good.
We have to turn this around and fast.
Garrus, didn't waste any time getting to work, I see.
After what I've been through lately, calibrating a giant gun is a vacation. Gives me something to focus on.
We're gonna need you for more than your aim.
Oh, I'm ready for it. But I'm pretty sure we'll still need giant guns. And lots of them.
Can't argue with that.
Yeah, so, is this the part where we shake hands? Wasn't sure about the protocol on reunions, or if you even still felt the same way about me. The scars are starting to fade. I remember they drove you wild. But I can go out and get all new ones if it'll help.
I want to know what happens if she does both. What? Let's just see. She probably is going to be like, well, you're with Liara, so you should help. Let's just see. All right? This is a renegade move. And seriously, why do you have to be like that, Garrus? I'm not even into it, but why do you have to be like that? It's very difficult for me to think long-term here when you say such things. Okay.
I haven't forgotten our time together.
Well, I've been doing some more research on human customs. I didn't want to...
Oh god. Oh shit. I'm gonna be confronted.
That's the protocol on reunions.
I'm gonna be
the
confronted.
The vids mentioned it might go something like that.
Oh god.
I had hoped it would. I mean,
I'm not used to this life.
I didn't know. If...
I can't promise how things will work out. Not with this war.
Mm.
But I missed you, Garrus.
Oh shit, Liara's
I thought about you a lot.
You're right.
Glad to know my romantic skills made an impression. Because it's going to take more than Reapers to come between this cross-species liaison.
What? Stop it.
Speaking of which, you said you're the expert advisor on Reapers now?
It's not as impressive as it sounds. I ruffled some feathers, so they gave me a token title, along with a token task force, so I'd shut up.
How'd you manage that?
Just followed your example, Shepard. Yell loud enough and someone will eventually come over to see what all the fuss is about. Not that they'll actually do anything about it.
Until hell shows up at their door. Then they put you in charge.
Not like the old days, is it? Rogue Spectre and C-Sec agents running and gunning outside the lines, making it up as we went along. We're actually respectable now.
We've lost enough friends trying to make sure this day never came. I'd say we've all earned some respect.
Then the first Reaper we take out with this gun, it's in their honor. Just give the word. Something else you want to talk about?
You mentioned you still had family on Palavin.
My father is there. Sister, too.
How long's it been since you heard from them?
Long enough to be worried.
I'm sure they're okay.
That's the thing about getting old, Shepard. The platitudes get just as old. Pretty soon, blind hope is all we'll have left. And I hate being blind.
I know you don't have any illusions about what we're up against, Garrus. How do you rate our chances?
I know it looks bad now, but I think we can win this, Shepard. For the first time since we met, we're not alone in the fight. It's something I learned long ago in C-Sec. An imminent and painful death has a way of motivating people. Instead of questioning your every word, whole civilizations are going to be begging you to save them.
After what's happened to Palavin, you still believe that?
I didn't say there wouldn't be casualties. It's something Turians are taught from birth. If just one survivor is left standing at the end of a war, then the fight was worth it. But humans want to save everyone. In this war, that's not going to happen.
So what's this Reaper task force you've been running?
After what happened to you out there in Batarian space, I knew time was running out. For all of us. The Citadel Council was a dead end, so I did something I never thought I'd do. I went to my father.
He used to work for C-Sec, didn't he? I seem to remember that the two of you didn't see eye to eye.
To put it mildly. But he still had heavy pull in the Turian government. The Primarch, well, the old one, was a friend of his. So I went to my father and laid out everything we knew about the Reapers, from Saren all the way to the Collector base.
Let me guess, he laughed in your face.
Amazingly, no. He just listened. My father may have been a pain in the ass about rules and regulations, but he never let politics cloud his judgment. If the connections were there, he wouldn't deny them, and he saw what we always knew. The Reapers were coming.
I'm glad someone finally agreed.
He did more than agree. He took it to the Primarch.
I like his style.
Except the Primarch wasn't as convinced. My father kept pushing and finally got him to commit some token resources. And if you call them a task force, it sounds like you did something about it.
What'd you do with it?
As much as I could get away with. And a little more. We hardened our lines of communications, expanded emergency stockpiles across the colonies, improved our early warning detection protocols.
You think it helped?
I'd like to think it bought our fleet some extra time. We'll know when this war is over.
So you can vouch for this new Primarch?
Well, even if I couldn't, you go to war with the army you have.
Will he live up to his word?
I've never known Victus to lie. Play fast and loose with strategy, maybe, but betray an ally. Not his style. Then if he did try, well, we'll just find another Primarch.
I noticed generals saluting you, Garrus. How far down the line of secession are you these days?
Let's not go there.
Why not? I've seen you in action. Think about it. Primarch Vicarian, honored war hero. Somebody's gonna have to rebuild Palavin when this is over.
Your confidence is inspiring, but it'll have to be someone who knows how to hold a hammer.
That's all for now, Garrus. But stay close. We've got some catching up to do.
Ooh. You know where to find me.
Okay.
And this time, I can afford the good stuff. Ooh. There are a few perks to being an expert Reaper advisor.
TME?
Deal.
Now, I'm sure somebody screwed up something down here. I want to get the old girl back in fighting shape.
Okay, to be real, and I wanted to say it. Since that happened, don't judge me. Oh my god, what's my cat doing? If the world is ending, like, what's the big deal, guys?
Positive, if you don't want to come over and talk.
No, the gun battery is nice and quiet. If I throw down some rocks, it'll get downright cozy. Hope
they're not talking about.
I'll be fine, Liara. Just
see, this could
thoughts.
Be a thing, guys. This All could right. be a real thing.
Ugh. A Prothean. A living, breathing Prothean right below me.
He's not what I expected.
Me neither. He was a little cold when I tried to talk. I understand the shock of waking up again. His species gone. But a Prothean, Shepard.
Sorry.
There's so much he could tell us.
The things this Prothean must have seen. If they had the technology to preserve someone for over 50,000 years, no wonder they were capable of building things like the device on Mars. Give him time. When will I get another chance? I'm not sure what to make of him. He wasn't inclined to talk. He's simply a soldier mourning his people. Or is it a fundamental difference in our... what was the word? In our cultures. Check out these implants. She's awake. Do you know where you are? You're in trouble. Cough. Oh god. Okay, so nothing is happening right now concerning that. Alright, we're gonna end it here. I don't know what's gonna happen as a result of my actions. I feel minimal guilt, but when faced with this, it's difficult to make a choice. Really, I mean, I just think it comes down to Garrus' writing is, like, amazing. And I feel like her delivery with Garrus, the voice actors, is really more natural. And I don't know what to say. All right, I'm going to go. See you in the next episode. Bye.